okay, you say? Tragic? But this couldn't happen to anyone in senior high school? If so, how come a safety report reveals that in one typical year, 1973, out of the 73 students that were killed in the loading and unloading area once they got off the bus, 18 students were junior high school age or older?
Where do you work?
Impossible, you think?
I work over McDonald's.
Tell that to Mary Malone here. She thought the same thing.
I'm really looking for that dance on Saturday.
Oh, I know. I hear the band is really good. Are you going?
Yeah.
Well, who are you going with?
Mike.
Mike? What are you going with Mike for?
Because he asked me.
She, like most of the others on this bus, are high school seniors. They were past that stage.
What happened to your hair?
It's stupid. It just got caught in the door.
Mind if I sign it?
I guess so.
Just
don't write it anything dirty.
Mind that magic marker here?
The driver, Sarah Brown, never expected anything to happen either. Never thought anything would mar her safety record. After all, Sarah knew these kids and their families and could almost anticipate their usual antics. Why, she was even prepared for the snow, but not for what Mary Malone was doing. When the snows come, Sarah Brown, being safety conscious, always makes sure she stops where there's a clearing in the snow so that students won't have to slip on snowbanks. To avoid potential trouble, Sarah Brown even drives more slowly when she crosses a bridge because she realizes the road surface on bridges ice up before the roads on either side of it and can cause a skid. Few could fault Sarah Brown for her diligence. Fewer still would have guessed today would have been any different from any other day. The snow, the bus, the teenagers, with things she could handle. Sarah was as cautious as usual, even in the more congested areas, making every attempt to stop at either driveways that have been cleared of snow or to let them off near sidewalks that have been shoveled. If she can't, she stops the bus away from a snowbank and waits for the students to get over them so that there is no chance they will slip under the bus. Like all good drivers, Sarah keeps track of everybody and their stops and never starts up until she's sure they're out of the death zones. She even double checks to make sure that they've cleared the area before she drives away. But for all her concern, the fun that you see starting here. Coupled with the snow and the ice at this next stop, will give Sarah Brown sleepless nights for the rest of her life. The boys in the bus have Mary's book. They plan to hand it out to her. Although she knows better, Mary climbs the snowbank to get it. The driver, seeing the byplay, waits, anticipating something could happen. Mary wants to obey Sarah, but can't get her book from the boys. Maybe a gentle reminder with the horn. At last, Mary has it and leaves the snowbank. Sarah Brown checks the mirror to be sure and starts up, never thinking Mary would come back. The local rescue squad worked quickly to get Mary out from under the wheels. And now, They race against time to get her to a hospital. But their efforts will be in vain. Because Mary Malone forgot to think about what could happen on a snowbank. Mary Malone need not think about the dance on Saturday night. Mary Malone will never again work at McDonald's or have to concern herself with what's to come after graduation. Somewhere on a country road in Vermont, life will be over for Mary Malone. Learn from her mistake. Stay off snowbanks. Be extremely careful whenever you get on or off a bus. Don't add your name to the list of those who have died in the death zones. Obey all of the school bus safety rules in your area. Live.
Country lady.